Hey everyone, in this tutorial, we will create a movie poster design by using the double exposure concept and GIMP. Let's begin. Let's create a new canvas in File, New, and it is this A4 template. Just hit OK. Next, add the image in here, but first we have to select it by going to File, Open, and it is this. Just hit Convert. This time we're going to do the in-depth selection in GIMP. You can see my previous video how to create a fantasy photo manipulation. It's the same method to do the in-depth selection. Right, first, duplicate this layer, click this icon, and make it black and white color with desaturate in color, desaturate, and click desaturate again. Just hit OK. Create more contrast with curves, go to color, curves, and just shrink down so you can see the black is more contrast in here, which is good for masking. In masking, the black color for hiding and white for reveal. Next, let's invert it because we want to take the woman in the selection, so it must be in the white color. By going to color, choose invert. Now we can see these white areas in white and this still in black color and gray. We have to make it fully white. So with bezier tool help, press B and just follow the shape. I start from here. Okay, just click and drag like this. And this. We can turn off this layer while selecting with the bezier tool. So just make sure you select these inner areas. Just to make sure you select gray area. When almost finished, hold control until you see this chain icon, then click, then press enter. Alright, now fill it with the white color, make sure you were in this layer, then go to edit. Fill with background color because our background color in this white color. And deselect it and go to select and choose none. Then click this icon. Now the last thing, make some contrast again with the curves. We go into color, curves, and just fully turn it down till you see it's become a silhouette. Then click OK. Okay, let's create a layer mask in the original. Right click, add layer mask and choose this white full opacity, then hit add. And on this layer, press Ctrl C to copy. And click on the mask layer, not the original. And Ctrl V to paste. Then click this enter icon. So you see, it will get this clean selection. Then right click, apply layer mask. Then move it to this canvas. And you can move it with the move tool or the shortcut is M. Run this. Right, select more image in file. Open. And I choose this. Is it convert? And do the same method by duplicating this layer. And make it black and white color in color, desaturate, and click desaturate again. And click OK. Make it more contrast with color, curves, and just turn it down like this because we want to invert it later. Just click OK. Then let's invert it in color and choose invert. Now with the bezier tool help, press B. We have to select these areas and the face. Okay, start from here. Okay, just select this gray area to make it become white color like this. Okay, we're almost finished. Hold control, then click and press enter. Then fill it with the white color, go to edit and choose fill with the background color. Alright, deselect it and select and choose none. And click this move tool to remove these lines. Create more contrast again with the curves. Go to color, curves, and just fully turn it down until you see the silhouette. And click OK. Same thing, create a layer mask, right click, add layer mask, choose this white full opacity, then hit it. Press Ctrl C to copy in this layer and Ctrl V to paste on this layer mask. And click this anchor icon. Turn off this layer and right click, just apply layer mask. And let's bring it to this canvas. With move tool, you can move it around here. Press Shift F, or you can go to here to flip. Make sure you choose the horizontal to flip it to the opposite direction. And with move tool, just move it around here. And for the last image, I'm going to do the same thing, so just let me speed it up. Okay, then move it to here. I just scale it down, press Shift S, hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional scale like this, and place it on here. And now we're going to use the double exposure concept in GIMP. Okay, let's hide this layer and duplicate it, click this icon. For easy to understand, so I'm just going to rename it to and this to, then change this layer mode to exit name, the soft light. But as we see nothing. It's because this background in this default white color, so just going to make some gray color around this, and with this bucket fill tool, or the shortcut is Shift B on the background layer, just click it. You will get this fade effect, this soft light, alright? Then let's turn on the normal. This time we're going to create the layer mask, so right click, add layer mask, just this white full opacity, then hit add, and this too. With paintbrush tool, you can press P for the shortcut, and make sure you active this black color, just swap it, click this icon. Now what we're going to do is hiding the normal and keep the fade effect in the soft light. So in the normal, in the mask layer, just brush it. So we'll get this fade effect. Try to reduce the hardness and increase the size. And in the soft light, brush it too. Swap it to white to make it reveal this. And for the main, just turn on this. Just going to do the same, just duplicate this layer and rename it to. Next step, we're going to create selection to the main from the woman shape. So just right click on this, on the woman layer, right click, all path to selection. And while in selection like this, and in this main layer, right click, add layer mask, and click selection. Right, as you can see, this is the soft light effect, and this is the normal. So do the same for the soft light, right click, add layer mask and choose the selection. Then deselect it and go to select and choose none. Now we're going to use the paintbrush tool. Make the face is completely revealed. You can swap this color to this. Make sure it's in the fully white color. And click OK. And on this layer mask, just brush it. And swap it with the black color for hide this part. Start with the normal layer. Then let's turn on this layer. Now for this, we can change layer mode to, let's try lectern only. Nice effect, just move it. I'm going to add more images in file. Open this layer and adjust this. Hit convert and scale it down a little by pressing shift S, then hold control shift while scaling to make it proportional scale. And place it around here and press enter. Click the selection with the woman layer to this layer, so just right click on the woman layer, right click alt path to selection. While in selection, go to this, right click, add layer mask and choose the selection, then hit it and deselect it and select none, or the shortcut is shift control A. Let's change layer mode to soft light. You will get this double exposure effect, and we can reduce this opacity if it's too much. Let's hide some part with the paintbrush tool, press P. Make sure you activate this black color and just brush it. One more image in file. Open this layer and adjust this, hit convert, scale it down by pressing shift control S and hold control shift while scaling, run here, create a selection from the woman layer, so right click, apply to selection, and on this, right click, add layer mask and choose the selection, deselect it by pressing shift control A. And change layer mode to addition. You can change layer mode as you want. Just find the best result for your project. So in this, I'm going to choose the addition. And hide this edge with the paintbrush tool, press P. Make sure you activate this black color. And on this mesh layer, just brush it. And the last for the text, press T and type the movie title. And press Ctrl A and change the font to, change the size to, with move tool, place it on here. Press T again and make some kern, change it to 10. So I'm just going to add more text by duplicating this. And with move tool, change the size to, change the text to, okay, and change the kern to 3. Add more text by just duplicating it. I don't know, I just put a random name from the internet, so let's change the type to bold. Place it on here. Increase the size to, it's still flipping for the white space, so I'm just going to resize all of this image. So click this to make the image link, then select one linked layer, shift S to scale, and hold Ctrl Shift while scaling around this and press enter. With move tool and hold shift to move all of this linked layer around here. Then I'm going to move this title. So let's unlink it and only link this. Place it around here. And the last for the movie production, so just going open up the PNG file, open this layer and choose this. And place it on the top by dragging it and move it down here. Around this. As we can see, the color is in gray, so make it black. So I'm just going to color, curves, and just shrink down and click OK. That's all. I hope you learned something new, how to create a movie poster design, especially for the in-depth selection and GIMP. Just keep practicing. Thanks for watching. I'm ZK from ZK Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.